Welcome to the last day of competition here at the 2017 Winter Universiade in Almaty, Kazakhstan. The closing ceremony is tonight, but sporting action was still underway this morning. First, we'll check up on the men's ice hockey semifinal games between Russia and Canada, and also Kazakhstan and the Czech Republic. Then, the women's 3,000-meter and men's 5,000-meter short track relay took place, where two Chinese athletes would earn medals. Then, finally, we'll head outside for the men's cross-country 30-kilometer mass start, which will help wrap up almost all the events here except for the men's ice hockey finals later tonight. Welcome to Halyk Arena for the semi-final matchup now between Russia and Canada. Russia is 4-0 heading into this one with two big 14-0 wins. They took those ones against Korea and Japan. Canada, they are also 4-0 heading into this one with one 14-0 game versus Great Britain. If you look here, the quarterfinals are Russia, Canada, and Czech Republic and Kazakhstan. We will see them next. The officials of the game come from Sweden, the USA, and Slovakia. Canada now taking to the ice. We can see the starting lineup here for Russia, as both captains here shake hands and exchange ceremonial gifts. The starting lineup now for Canada. The head coach for Russia is Vlad Kromek, and for Canada, it's Brett Gibson. Getting ready to kick things off here. Russia would score in every single period of this game. In fact, they'll be the only team to score in this first period. Canada just won't be able to get the puck in the net. To start off the action, Russia on the power play. A slap shot from Zabornikov will get Russia the 1-0 lead in the first period. Watch this one again. Just centimeters past the goalie's glove. That one is good to end the first. In the second period now, Canada would look to answer back as Slater Doggett steals the puck, goes all the way around the goalie, but some great stick work there by the goalie just puts it right out of the net. You can see here, almost goes in. Doggett looks back to see if he was successful. This one is no good for Canada. Canada desperate for a goal in this second period. A shot here from Guillaume Asselin. Almost goes in, the ref calling it off here. We're gonna get another angle. Watch how close this goes to the line here as goalie Andrukov just swipes it out. Russia now on the other end would pick up their second goal of the game. Watch this one. Artem Osipov slides into the goalie. That one is gonna be good here for Russia. 2-0 now over Canada. You can see that top shelf lifts it up over the goalie's left shoulder. Russia now at the end of the second leads 2-0. And to start off the third period, Russia would get tons of shots on net. A great stop there by the Canadian goalie. You can see getting his stick and his pads down, stopping Arofiev's shot. Next up was Osipov's turn. A fast break, but once again, great positioning by the Canadian goalie. Watch this one, right into his chest. That one no good for Russia. But Arrowview's second attempt in this third period, a slap shot from deep, gets it over right past the goalie. That one on the two-person power play would bring Russia to 3-0 now over Canada. Russia extremely happy with this goal, leading by 3 late in the third with a minute and a half left. It was Ivan Ivanov who would get another empty netter to put them up by 4 with under a minute and a half left to go in the third period. Let's watch this one more time. No goalie, no problem for Ivanov. But now 20 seconds on the clock. Canada still going 100%. Guillaume Asselin from right on top of the crease gets one to go past that Russian goalie. You can see here, slings it in on the right-hand side. Canada now has 1 point, still behind 4-1, though, to Russia. On the clock now, not looking good for Canada, under 10 seconds in the third period. And you can tell they're unhappy because look at this interaction now between Russia's Daniel Ehlin and Canada's Ryan Van Strelen. It's going to start an absolute brawl here at the end of the game. You can see Canada and Russia going at it. Multiple players now fighting with each other. The refs trying to stop it here. You can see this rivalry between these two hockey teams goes deeper than any other at these games. Team Russia not trying to get involved in this one. They're going to take this 4-1 win now over Canada. Russia will move on to the gold medal game. Canada over to the bronze. 4 goals by Russia. Zabornikov, Osipov, Arafiv, and Ivanov will get them the 4-1 win. Canada's only goal scored by Asselin. Shots on net, Russia 34, Canada 16. Was a close one in that regards, but Russia a little bit more accurate on this one. They will go now. Gold medal. We will see the semifinal matchup now on the other end between the Czech Republic and Kazakhstan. The winner of that game will play Russia for the gold medal in the Universiad. For this next one, we will stay at Halyk Arena to enjoy some more semifinal action for men's hockey. This one will be Kazakhstan and the Czech Republic. The last time these two met up, it was 8-0 for Kazakhstan. They're 4-0 heading into this one with a 22-0 win over China and also wins against Sweden and the Czech Republic. This team, they're 3-1 heading into this one. Again, their only loss has been to Kazakhstan with wins versus Sweden, China, and Slovakia. This is the second semifinal game that we're watching here tonight. We watched earlier just the first one, Russia versus Canada. That was a 4-1 victory for Russia as they move on to the gold medal game. The fans for Kazakhstan now hoping that they pull out the win in this semifinal matchup again, moving them to the gold medal game. The referees for this matchup are from Spain, Slovakia, Canada, and Sweden. You can see here two players from each team will exchange gifts. The coach for Kazakhstan, Sergei Starygin. Take a look now at the starting lineup. Czech Republic, their coach is Jaroslav Liska, and here's their starting lineup. Here's the referee now getting ready to kick off this semifinal action here at Halyk Arena. The Czech Republic looking to get a win over Kazakhstan. Kazakhstan looking to keep their 0-goal record against Czech Republic intact. They would take early possession in this game, but it was the Czech Republic who would have the best shot attempts in this first period. Let's watch here as number 25, Marek Bale, gets a shot attempt there. The goalie, no problem for him, knocks it right down. But the Czech Republic wouldn't stop now at the end of their power play in this first period. Jan Muller gets another shot on net. He goes down, tries to sink that one in even from the ground. We'll take another look at this shot right here. Here's Muller around two defenders, gets bumped down, still trying to get that goal in, however. But it would be the Czech Republic's Daniel Arnos who would be the first to score in this game. 1-0 Czech Republic. A beautiful pass there by Stastny over to Arnos. Right past the goalie. Czech Republic takes the lead. But Kazakhstan wanted back in this one. An error from the Czech Republic's defenseman. Get a wide open Savenkov right in front of the net. Watch here. Just slices it in as he takes a dive. He ties it up now. 1-1, Kazakhstan and the Czech Republic. It would be Kazakhstan that would kick off the second period now as well. As Georgi Dulnev gets another shot on goal here. You can see a slap shot from deep. But the Czech Republic's Josef Novak would stop that one. He has 12 saves right now on 13 shots. but it wouldn't be long before Kazakhstan would get their next goal. We take a look here at the last shot attempt, but it would be Dmitry Grents who actually gets it in the net now. You can see him slicing and dicing in front of the crease here. Watch this one again. Right top left shelf. It's good to bring Kazakhstan up by one now. But the scoring wouldn't stop for this home team. A slap shot from Akhlzin gets Kazakhstan up now by two. Watch this one once again. Slings it back right over the left shoulder of the goalie. They lead 3-1 now heading into the third period. The last period now in the game. Another goal now for Kazakhstan. This one is credited to Alex Ansarov. Watch here, just wraps it around right over. He looks up to the skies. Kazakhstan now leads 4-1 in this last period. But the Czech Republic did not give up. Still almost 16 minutes left in the third. A shot attempt here by Marek Kaluza would get Kazakhstan riled up here. And again, the coach still looking for some action from his players. As they continue on, David Zakhar finds himself open in front of the net. Another shot attempt for the Czech Republic. Watch this one once again. Great positioning there by the Kazakhstan goalie. You can see from another angle, right off of his chest. Czech Republic happy with the attempt. Kazakhstan happier now with the score. 5 seconds left to go. The Czech Republic, they take it easy for the last few. Kazakhstan will take this one 4-1. In the semifinal match, they will now head to the gold medal game. The Czech Republic will move on to the bronze medal game against Canada, and Kazakhstan will take on Russia for the title of 1-2. Shots on net today, Kazakhstan 30, the Czech Republic only 20. Both coaches now shake hands, congratulate each other on a match well played as Kazakhstan skates around the arena, thanking all their fans who came out to support them. It was loud in there, and it'll be even louder for the gold medal game, Kazakhstan versus Russia. We'll stay in the ice rink now, but we'll move over to Ballinsholuk Short Track Arena, where we will watch the women's 3,000-meter relay and the men's 5,000-meter relay team here, with athletes from Korea, Japan, China, Russia, and Kazakhstan. First up, we will watch the women's 3,000-meter relay speed skating event. You can see here Korea, China, Japan, and Kazakhstan represented in this race. You'll get a look at the Korean team here. Now, the four Chinese athletes will get a quick cheer in before the race. And Japan's athletes. Last but not least, the hometown team, four athletes from Kazakhstan. To start the race off here, the four athletes get going quickly into this 3,000-meter relay. You can see their teammates kind of go on the inside of the ring around them, getting ready to take their spot. They get a nice little push from their teammates, and then they take a lap as well. 23 laps to go here. This race will go for about 4 minutes. We're almost a minute into this one. Korea leading the way, followed by China and Kazakhstan. Japan in last place. 12 laps to go here. It's still Korea in the lead, China just behind. Kazakhstan takes a quick lead here, but Korea takes it right back. 2 laps to go here. It's Korea and China at the beginning. Final lap here. Korea still leading the way. The Chinese athlete doing her best to catch up here. Look at how close this was. Korea takes the gold. China the second. Watch this as they make their final exchange for their last lap of this 3,000 meter. It's going to go Korea, China, Kazakhstan will pick up the bronze. Next up is the men's 5,000 meter relay. Russia will get in on the action here with Korea, China, and Kazakhstan. Here's the Korean team, followed by the athletes from China. The four hometown athletes here from Kazakhstan, including Denis Nikisha, who's picked up a few medals at this Universiade, and the Russian team. This race may look like it's not as fast, but when these guys get going, it is almost impossible to watch all the action. 10 seconds into this race, China has the lead. Kazakhstan moves from fourth to third in this one, but it wouldn't end up that way. You gotta watch the whole race to find out the exciting ending. Four minutes into this one, China leads the way, followed by Korea and Kazakhstan. Russia, they're in last. Twelve laps to go here. It's still China, Korea, and Kazakhstan. Korea now takes an outside lane, grabbing that first place position as they go into another exchange. It's now Korea, Kazakhstan, China. Seven laps to go here. It's now Korea in the front as Kazakhstan takes the outside lane, grabs that first position. Now they're leading the way. It's a close one here between Korea and Kazakhstan as they go around. Kazakhstan leading the way now, two laps to go. Final lap here. This is when all the excitement happens. Korea and Kazakhstan take this corner a little too sharp. They're both knocked out. China comes around and he's going to claim the gold medal for his country. Look at how happy he is there. First place, China. Watch this one. A little too tight between these two. They're both knocked out. It's Korea first, then Kazakhstan, both into the sides of the race. Kazakhstan not happy with this, then they were leading the way for most of the time, but China will take it, then Russia, Kazakhstan will grab gold. Back to the women now, it's Korea who get the first place. Gold medal for this team here. Here they are, the 3,000 meter relay. Great race by those women, followed by the China and Kazakhstan picks up the bronze. Now for the men, the Chinese athletes have won gold in this 5,000 meter relay event. The flags were raised for China, Kazakhstan, and Russia, and this will end the short track speed skating event. Welcome now to Alito Cross Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex. Athletes from around the world participated in this last cross-country event. Athletes from Mongolia, Norway, Belarus, Lithuania, Switzerland. I could go on and on, but leading the way is Russia and Kazakhstan athletes. One guy from Japan, and they're off. This race will last over 1 hour and 19 minutes. We're almost 10 minutes now into this race. Three Russian athletes leading the way in the pack of athletes in this one. Over 60 men would compete for this gold medal. You can see here Russia in 1, 2, 3. Kazakhstan takes 4 and 5. Ukraine, 6. Almost 13 minutes now into this one. 5 kilometers in, these athletes still going head to head in that front pack. You can see a couple athletes follow closely behind. Leading the way now is a Kazakhstan athlete, still Russia, Russia, Kazakhstan, right up in the front there. You can see approaching the 13:10 mark. Gontor leading the way for Russia. He's cleaned up at these Universiades, collecting just a few medals, and he's going to go for another one here today. 26 minutes into the race, 10 kilometers in. Just to remind you, this is a 30-kilometer race, so just about one-third done here. Gontor still leading the way. Right behind him is Rostovtsev. And he takes the lead now. Gontor in second. Two Kazakhstan athletes in third and fourth. It's Malyshev and Gontor in the front there. 15 kilometers in, approaching the 40-minute mark as Gontor comes out in front. A little bit of a pattern here. You can see Russia, Kazakhstan, Gontor in the lead. These four would end up at the very end in 1, 2, 3, and 4, but the order does change up quite a few times before that. As you can see, Russian athlete takes the lead on this one. 52 minutes into the race now, it's Russia, Kazakhstan, Kazakhstan, Russia. Russia's Gontor in the lead. Rostovtsev making moves now. He's wearing the number one bib there. You can see he's going hard at the 20-kilometer mark to get into that first place position. Gontor still leading the way. Rostovtsev right behind, and the two Kazakhstan athletes in third and fourth. All four of them sprinting up the hill. A grueling race here. We're over an hour, 1:03. As a Kazakhstan athlete makes his way into the lead, that's Malyshev. Like I said, these four would end up on top, but the order would change throughout the race. You can see here, Kazakhstan, Russia, Kazakhstan, Russia. It's Malyshev in the lead right now, followed by Gontor. Rostovtsev in third. And Pushkalo, he's in fourth. kilometers here. They're approaching the end. Leading the way right now is Rostovtsev for Russia. He's in the number one bib. Beside him in the four, that's Valery Gontor. The crowd cheers them on as they get closer to the finish line. Getting there right now, they make their last sprints. You can see here, leading the way is a Kazakhstan athlete, but it would be Gontor who would make a run for it. You can see him in four. Number one bib is Rostovtsev. They're gonna cross the finish line almost at the same time. It's gonna be whoever has the heart to go first. Taking the gold is Russia's Dmitry Rostovtsev. Valery Gontor takes the silver, and in third place, it's Sergei Malyshev. After an hour and 20 minutes, these athletes are completely exhausted, but it will be worth it in the end. Here's Rostovtsev. He gets the gold medal again. Russia, Russia, Kazakhstan, Kazakhstan, absolutely dominating in this 30-kilometer race. You can see Rostovtsev getting his gold medal. That's his third at this Universiade. He also picked up one silver. Here's all the athletes here. Again, Russia, Russia, Kazakhstan to end the cross-country event.